Leo Gonzalez is on the mound for game two. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Gio Gonzalez, quality lefty. First thing you think of when you think of Gio, that big overhand curveball. Might be one of the best curveballs in baseball. Pretty good fastball, too. 92 to 93 miles an hour. That big overhand hook and a straight changeup. Really quality pitcher.
Coming to the plate now, Javier Baez. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. First pitch of the at-bat. Underway in our nation's capital as the first pitch is looked at for ball one. And now look out as Ed runs in and gets him. And a very interesting start to this one. First pitch coming. Here it is. A ball and no strikes. And there are the umpires assigned to this one. Calling balls and strikes is Mr. Carl Dixon.
Dan, this is an offensive player's dream to have Carl Dixon behind the dish. He is tight on the corners.
He is, D-Ro. And listen, he makes you bring the ball into the strike zone. Normally, high scoring a game when Carl's behind the dish.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there. But if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further down. Maybe even potentially bounce the next one.
And it's fouled away. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. Stanton's on the warning track as he hauls it in for a loud out number one. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And that one just missed outside. Baez leads off first with one away. Rounded down the third baseline. But a foul ball. One and one. Line towards center field. Margot is there to put it away. And the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Batting fourth.
First pitch on its way. Right over the middle, knee high. Two out base runner aboard in the top of the first. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
You know that nasty changeup's lurking right here. If I'm in the batter's box, I have to tell myself to stay back. I have to take full side out of the equation, or that changeup's going to beat me.
Well, there's a case, not that bad of a pitch, 0-2, D-Roll, but something he'd like to get down and bury in the strike zone, no doubt about it.
Yeah, ground ball with eyes right there. Nice job by the offensive player just to battle. 0-2's a tough spot to be in. He battled.
Anthony Rizzo is in with two away as he takes a ball, 1-0. 1-1, the count to the Cubs' first baseman.
I don't blame the batter for pulling the trigger right there. Those fastballs light up your eyes, and you can occasionally do damage with them. But he wasn't able to catch up with that one.
Two down, runners at first and second. Now Rizzo belts one, carrying well into right field. And this one is gone, a home run. That home run is definitely worth giving the show track treatment to. And as we look at it, not only an impressive distance shot, but the 110 miles an hour exit velocity is nothing to scoff at either. That's a big boy home run. Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras, as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. Contreras in front, two balls and no strikes.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task.
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. But the Cubs do get three on the three-run home run. Home half. And a look now at the hometown Nationals starting lineup. D-Ro, what you got on this lineup tonight?
Well, Matty, this lineup's going to have to find a way to score early. Get this pitcher uncomfortable. Stay on the attack. Get into the bullpen. That's the name of the game. They let this guy settle in. He'll breeze through seven strong.
Cue shot here out towards short. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. One batter in, and the Cubs are going to have to handle a threat to run on the base paths. Digging in, DJ LeMahieu.
Boy, this is just a case of another really good hitter finding a way, even though that was a soft liner, finding a way to get hits.
Yeah, he usually gets.
And hold on there. That's not going to get him in there with the stolen base.
Some managers treat the postseason as a time to be aggressive, and that's exactly the case here. They had the speed burner on the move, and it worked out nicely for him. Just got to drive him in now.
And he will make a quick basket catch behind the plate for the first out. At the plate, Mo Evans. First delivery to him on the way. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss.
This is the stuff that infuriates a manager. You have to think the game. You got to know he's trying to pitch around you. You cannot swing at that pitch out of the zone.
1-1. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. In the dirt, and now let's see. And it's too late as he's in there. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
That can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball has gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it. He was there, and now he's only 90 feet away.
Catch made in left. Here comes the runner for the plate. And he will beat the tag, safe at the plate.
Boy, this one looked like he was headed for extra bases off the bat. Instead, a line drive bullet caught in the alley, but he does end up getting a sacrifice fly.
Giancarlo Stanton now. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
I think if he executes that pitch on the corner instead of off of it, he probably gets some pretty weak contact, if anything. He jammed him pretty hard on the previous pitch, so my bet was he was going to try to cheat on the inside part, thinking it might be coming again.
The 1-2. Takes this the other way to right, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. He'll get it into second. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
Man, that's surprising, Dan. This guy's flailing that stuff in the dirt above his head to get to two strikes, and then he lays in the cookie.
Boy, you would think after throwing two pitches out of the zone that he would triple up and throw a third one, either up, down, or in and out, but that one right in the middle of the strike zone.
3-0 with the first pitch. Here it comes. Takes a knee-high fastball. In past meetings with Jose Quintana, comes in with 6 hits in 33 at-bats. Fouled off. Quintana sets. Here it is on 0-2. A ball and 2 strikes.
Wow, that's a tough pitch to take. 0-2 fastball just off the corner, and I mean just off the corner.
And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Stanton stands at second with 2 gone. Heading out towards shallow right. Hayward is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. In now, Albert Almora. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Way in front of that fastball. High in the air down the right field line. Stanton has a read on it, one away. So striding in, Addison Russell, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And that's by him. It's 0-1.
Yeah, guys, the key to hitting in the big leagues is to hit off the heater, and this guy is obviously sitting something else.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. The 1-1 home. He's outside for a ball. Line to second where it's caught there for out number two. And with two away, let's check in with our up-to-the-minute playoff bracket. And you can see our series at 1-0 as things are starting to heat up here as we get later into October. Good change up there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. Liner toward right center. But he will run this one down in right center. A tough L9 in the end. And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
Hey, we're still in the early stages of this one. They're only down by a couple of runs. But it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on.
He dives. Did he catch that? He did. What a play there for the first down.
Great jump on that ball hit to the gap in right center field. A great diving catch. One of the better plays you'll see.
First delivery to him on the way. Ripped toward the gap in right. Segura turns and goes to second. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Yeah, some guys have the ability to rise the occasion, while some guys shrink away when it matters the most. Well, this guy is a gamer. He's been on fire since the postseason started, and after that hit, it looks like he doesn't plan on stopping anytime soon.
Swing and a miss, 0-1. Segura, the runner at second with one away. Takes a good curveball at the knees.
Hey, two tough pitches right there, and expect more of the same. With that guy standing out on second base, you don't want any RBI scoring right here. With that base open at first, he's going to grind out and try and get this guy to swing at something outside the zone.
Count is 1-2 now. One and two, here it comes. Now a swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. One out and a runner on second base. And even 2-2 count to the Nationals catcher. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2. Hit on the ground to third. Bryant is up with it. In time to first, and there are two away. Ready now, Gio Gonzalez, runner in scoring position with Sugan. Here comes the first pitch. A bouncer up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field. And the run will score from second as they cut it to one at 3-2 now.
Boy, that's a tough one right there if you're a pitcher, D-Lo. You're facing the opposing pitcher, and you give up a two-out RBI.
I got to believe he's contemplating retirement. A two-out not given up to the opposing pitcher.
Listen, as a pitcher, you hate to give up base hits, but you doubly hate to give up base hits to the opposing pitcher.
Into the box now, Cesar Hernandez. Check swing, too close to call, so the appeal goes down to Eric Summersgill, who says he did go around. That's strike one. And this one gets away. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. And he chased it in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. one in the inning for the Nationals. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Javier Baez, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Up and away to start the inning, it's 1-0. Not close, it's 2-0.
Boy, he just looks locked in at the plate right now to me. His numbers in recent games have been very good, and those were two stone-cold takes right there that put himself in a great hitter's count.
The lefty Jason Hayward waits in the on-deck circle, and he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Runners off for second. Popped him up. Hernandez is over, and he's got it for the first out of the inning. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up. Here's Chris Bryant now, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. First offering on its way. My fastball is in there.
You know, if I'm the hitter right here, I'm like, okay, you want to come get some early in the count? I was about to wait you out, but now game on.
And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. A ball and a strike now to Bryant. Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. The 1-2 lifted in the air to right field. On the move is Stanton. He's got it, and there are two down now. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Baez breaks from first. Strike taken, the throw. And he is out at second. Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. First pitch of the at-bat. Strike one to start the at-bat. Oh and one, here it comes. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball, ball one. Up. Rizzo is under it, makes the play, one away. Now to the plate, Mo Evans. First offering on its way. Here's a high pop up. Rizzo over to his left, makes the play, and there are two gone now. Trying to pick things up where he left off.
Giancarlo Stanton, one for one, as he reached base with a double his first time up.
Swung on and missed for the first strike.
Super important situation right here for the pitcher to go 1-2-3. Get back in the dugout, regroup. He struggled early, but if he can knock out this 1-2-3 inning, I think he can right the ship.
Happ is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire. Into the box now, Ian Happ, as we begin the top of the fourth. And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. A two-ball, no-strike count to the Cubs center fielder. Happ with a 2-1 count now.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Pound two balls in, and they get right back outside. Nice pitch.
Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. Anthony Rizzo stands in now. He hit a big three-run bomb in his first plate appearance. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1.
0-1's the count.
He was able to foul that one off, but you could tell he was definitely late. That breaking ball, the pitch before that heater right there, definitely threw his timing off.
Got him. Striding in once again, Wilson Contreras comes into this at-bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Fiftieth pitch of the game on its way. in there, and it's 0-2 now.
Hey, you think back to the early innings right there, you thought this guy would have been hitting his showers. A credit to him. He's been able to regroup, find his mechanics, and find a way to stay in this game.
A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. The next 1-2 pitch. And another foul ball. Another one sent foul. Three runs, just two hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out this side in order. The first baseman Miguel Cabrera stands in. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. First pitch on its way. Missed with a breaking ball. And he fouls this one off. Fastball stays way up that time for ball two. Oh, he wanted that one, but it misses for ball three.
He's been throwing strikes all day. So you're not up at the plate thinking he's going to walk you in this situation. You need to be aggressive and sit hard at the plate.
And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Here's the 3-2. Hard hit ball to second. Baez has it. No problem here. One away. Standing in,
Manuel Margot.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Hit back up the middle. And into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Gene Segura standing in. There goes Margot. Popped him up. Rizzo in foul ground. He's got it, and there are two down now. Striding in,
Yasmani Grandal.
He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Pitch inside. The throw is not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw. Well, when a stolen base is that close, it's interesting to check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, you'll want to focus on the top speed. Really good, and it paid off there. This is line to left, and that's in there. Base hit. The tying run is in to score from second.
Boy, I don't know about that pitch selection right there, Dealer. You have a base open with the pitcher on deck. Not very good pitching right there.
Dan, as a guy who hit eighth in the National League a time or two, nothing's more difficult than to try and mind meld with the pitcher and come up with a game plan when you know you got the pitcher on deck. Shocking that he was coming after him right there in that big spot, and he paid the price.
Now a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now. The 1-1 home is swung on and missed for strike number two.
That is such a tough pitch to lay off right there, but you have to find a way. There's nothing you're going to do with that low sinker except foul it into your shin or hit a ground ball to the left side.
And a hard sinker there, chopped foul at home plate. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Here now the 2-2. He swung on and missed strike three. Two hits in the inning lead to a run for the Nationals. We played four full, and we are all tied at three apiece. And now here's the versatile outfielder out.